So potentially in the last video tutorial we dealt so much on CSS and we left this. So what we want to animate, we want to animate this input, and when we click we want it to go up in an animated manner. We don't want it to go up, and we are not going to use much. We are going to use some few jQuery for this, but not much. We are going to rely so much on CSS animations. So potentially if you are new to this, what you are seeing this is when we focus on this, what do you want the child to do? This must be child, and that's why you found me putting a label below this. So potentially if you put the label above, let me just show you something if you are still following along with this. If you put the label for this and you put it there, then come here and refresh the page and you try to click, it won't go up because it's not a child for that. So that's why I put the label before. Okay, so hopefully comrades, you've understood why we have to do that, why we have to put the label or underneath the input so that it can be labeled when you focus on it to have it triggered. So let me just go to the main of CSS very much and come to the label, and I should give it some transition. So transition should be for all, and transition should be all. Okay, all properties, and you're going to have for 0.3 second, and you're going to have is and waiting or duration time for animation should be 0 second, and then I do something like this. Now you can see my label is animated. Potentially what I wanted to, anytime I animate, I might want to increase the font size, and the font size should be something like 15 pixel. Yeah, when I put it up, when it goes up. Okay, so we have something like that. Potentially we have that. So what you're going to do, we still have a problem on this, because if I put a name like Benson and I focus out, you can see it's going up. We don't want it to go up when this label is, it has some content in it. And one thing that I'm going to change is the color of my input. So also the color of my input should be changed completely to be something like 069. I don't know if that is almost like blue, so I'm going to change it. That's why I like PHP Phantom, because PHP Storm I like it so much because it gives me the functionality to change the C to manipulate the CSS. Oops, it doesn't, to manipulate the CSS property right away without having to reference anywhere. So for this, I just want to structure this in a very nice manner, but I don't know how it's going to appear. So potentially, I don't know if this is still not the real one. So the only thing that I'm going to do is font width to be bolder, because we want it to be seen very well. Yeah, we want to see what the user is entering inside. So what you're saying, we are saying we still have a very very great problem on this, because when I focus out, you can see we are having some problem. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a class that is called has value. And this class is going to check if we have a value for that. So has, so dot has value, and this has value is going to take this these properties, and probably we might also want to say font width. At this point it should be bolder, it should be bolder. So when I come here to the system and I do something like that, you're gonna see you're having a bold font on entering. So add this here. We don't want to waste much time on CSS. We don't want to waste much time on CSS. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to now include my jQuery. because you know, so when I come here to the page and I come here to so I should include the script, so and I'm going to say src equal to scripts, and I'm going to go for jQuery.js. Now I have my jQuery installed in my file, so now I gonna now put, try to see if my jQuery is working. So sorry, why am I making all this setup? So now I'm going just to confirm and say so worked. Then I'm going to refresh the page and you're gonna see it say worked. So that means the system is working pretty much nice, and I like this. Okay, so the next thing that we are going to do, we are going to look for this class has value, and this time I would like to be more professional. We don't want to put any script inside here. All we shall be doing, we shall be including our script. So inside the scripts folder, I'm going to create a new JavaScript file, and this is a new script. And it's going to be a JavaScript file, and this JavaScript file I'm going to call it main. I'm going to call it main, and inside the main I'm going to have the main there, and I'm going to paste some functionality of my code here. Okay, so in my index I'm going to make sure that my main has been included and it's working very well. So I'm going to say so src equals to scripts, and we're going to go to main.js. yeah, so potentially you know now it's working. So all we are going to do, we are going to check for our ul.nice inputs, and what you're looking on is our list, and then inputs, our child input, that's what you are looking on. Dot focus, this you're going to time, you're going to say dot focus out, this is function dot focus out function. Potentially you have something like this dot focus out function. When we focus out function, you're going to say so value content is equal to this dot val. So if content is equals to nothing, or if content is equal to nothing, you're going to say this dot remove, this dot remove class has value. So my class that I have is has value. For that I'm going to go back to the main.css and potentially do something here. So we are going to paste that there, input dot has value, and we are going to deal with label. Yeah, you have it there. So what you are saying, we are going to say this dot remove the class has value, else. So we just need to copy this once more. So I tried how to put else, but it never worked. But if it might work for you, then you're gonna go for it. So ul nice input focus function where content is good. If function is not equal to this, then you're going to add class. That's all we have for that. So let me just test. So I put that, and you're gonna see it is well formatted now. So it won't go back. Then you remove, you're gonna see it's going back. Okay, so all you're remaining into, we are through with CSS, we are through with our CSS. So this one, we are through with it, we are through with our CSS. The only thing that we're remaining is to put the bar on to the button to handle the event for our system. So input type, potentially now we may need to put some input, some button. So some button that you're going to structure it very well. This is the last part on CSS, so you know CSS is much boring for those people who know it, but it's nice because you might know something that you didn't know. So so ID, I'm going to say log in, and that's all I need, and I'm going to say login. So I have that. So now I have the login button. So this one, I'm going to structure it with the CSS potentially to make it look nice. We are going to have more multiple functionality in this, so I should put a list there, and inside here I'm going to say href equals to somewhere we don't know, because we are going to create this and forgot password. We shall also be looking on this functionality, very nice. And last list, because I want to show you how you can have forgot password functionality. I'm going to say href equals to register, or maybe we might put something there. So then you're going to say create a new account. Yeah, so you have it there. You have something like this. You have forgot password, you have create a new account, and that's all we need for that. So now it's just to structure our button login, and we come here and create button. So okay, button login, and you're going to say color to be white. So color to be white. So background to be navy. So okay, padding to be 7 pixel as usual. So border to be none. So and potentially border radius to be 5 pixel. Okay, border radius should be 5 pixel. And then I come here and I refresh and I see what I have. I have this login. So the only thing that I can do is to put cursor, potentially is to put a cursor. So cursor to be pointer, and we have it there. So by default this one, I might also need to change the color of my label while I've not focused it. So the color of the label, we're gonna change it to be something like so that we can see that animation to be something like 666, just to be something like right gray, so that yeah, we have it like that. And when somebody so we need to change this color to be black. And also for our class as value, we are also going to change color to be black. Okay, so then we have something like this. Yeah, and if you put your name, you focus out, it's still going to work very nice. So potentially all we gonna do is something something we've not done. We are going to come here to the index, before I finish on this video tutorial, and potentially I might be having div.login h4 display to be block, and border bottom to be 1 pixel, solid hash e1 e1 e1. Yeah, I have it there. So there, potentially the next thing that I can adjust to is just give it some box shadow, some very very unnoticeable box shadow of hash a1 a1 a1, and this is going to be 1 pixel 1 pixel 1 pixel. Yeah, great. So yeah, I think well, it is like that, it looks nice. Okay, that's all for this video tutorial. In the next video tutorial, I don't see anything that we've left on CSS. We are just going to go direct to our programming, or to our programming for the PHP and starting the new functionality for this. Goodbye, meet you in the next video tutorial. If you like this video, remember to subscribe, remember to like. I love you all. Goodbye.